And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala throughout the Quran, and we see in the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, many different names for this day. Why is that? And so some of the scholars like Imam al-Qurtubi rahimullah, they listed over 50 different names for it. So let us cover quickly some of the names, perhaps 20 of the names, so that we can understand a little of the perspectives regarding these names for the Day of Resurrection. The first name and the most commonly used in the Quran is Yawm al-Qiyamah. And this is mentioned in at least 70 different verses. The day of standing, the day of rising, the day of standing before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Another name is Al-Yawm al-Akhir, the final day, because there is no day after that. There is only eternity after that. Another name that is used is As-Sa'ah, the hour. Another name that is used is Yawm al-Ba'th, the day of resurrection, the day in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will resurrect all man and jinn. Another name that is used is Yawm al-Khuruj, the day of coming out from the graves. Another name that you'll see in the Quran is Al-Qari'ah, the striking hour. Imam al-Qurtubi rahimahullah said, this is because it will strike the hearts with terror. Or so people will be stricken with the calamities of time, the terrors and calamities of time. Another name that is used is Yawm al-Fasl, the day of judgment or decision. So Allah, yafsilu baynum, He will decide between the people. He will decide between the people regarding that which they deferred and disputed about. Another name that you'll see in the Quran is Yawm al-Din, the day of recompense. And so this is the day of reckoning because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish or reward people based on what they did. Another name that was used, and these are two names that are connected, is As-Sakha and At-Tama. And so this is the first blowing of the trumpet, and this is the second, At-Tama, the greater catastrophe for the day of resurrection. Another name that is often used is Yawm al-Hasra, the day of grief and regret, because many people on that day will be filled with grief and regret. You do not want to come on the day of judgment with regret, because regret on that day, you cannot do anything with it. There's no way to ransom yourself. And so the disbelievers on that day will be filled with regret, and those who committed many sins and did not repent will also be in a state of regret and grief. Another name that is used is Al-Ghashiyah, that which is overwhelming, or Yawm al-Khulud, the day that is eternal, or Yawm al-Hisab, the day of reckoning, or Al-Waqi'ah, the event that is to take place, or Yawm al-Wa'id, the day of warning, or Yawm al-Azifa, the day that is drawing near. Another name that is used is Al-Haqqah, that which is inevitable. Another name that is used is Yawm al-Talaq, with a ta and not a ta, and this is the day of mutual meeting, because people will meet one another. And some scholars said, like Ibn Kathir said, that Ibn Abbas said, that this is the day that Adam alayhi salam will meet the last of his children. Others said that people will meet their deeds on that day. So Yawm al-Talaq. And there's also a name, Yawm al-Tanad, that is used in the Quran. This is the day in which there will be mutual calling between people. And the last one that we'll mention is Yawm al-Taghabun, the day of mutual loss and gain. And this is the day that many people will lose and many people will be disgraced, while many others will have a lot to gain from the rewards and from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.